Hey guys, it's Green Girlene here, and in today's video, I'm going to be teaching you about storyboarding. Now, your first question might be, Girlene, what is storyboarding? Well, storyboarding is basically a visual plan similar to a comic strip that's going to give us a rough idea of what our story is going to be for our animation. Now, a storyboard is usually cut up into 6 main scenes that's going to give you an idea of what happens throughout the plot of your story or animation. The storyboard will be a great way to plan out your animation before you begin it, and also be a great thing to look back to as an outline while you're going through and making the frames for your animation. Your next question might be, well, what do I put on my storyboard? Your storyboard is going to have your 6 defining scenes, so each scene will give you enough information about the environment in the scene, the background, and what the characters are doing. And there should be enough information in each scene where someone who doesn't know the story could follow along with it, but also not too much, so it's not too detailed or taking up too much time, because it's not our real animation, it's just an outline. So, to give you an example of all the stuff I've just talked about, I'm going to bring it all together on my iPad here. So let's take a look. So, I have a storyboard on my iPad here. Let's just walk through it so you can get an example of what to do for your animation. For my animation, I want to have a story of a fish going through the water that sees a shark that gets scared and hides from it. So my first scene, we have an angle of the fish straight ahead, just swimming along, and I have some kelp or seaweed in the background that helps set the tone for my animation and for that scene. The next scene is just going to be the shark, and it's swimming along for some suspense. The third scene is a scene that's important because the fish is swimming along, but it's still smiling because it doesn't notice the shark there. The shark's swimming along looking for some food, but it doesn't know that the fish is there. This scene is where the fish notices the shark. Now, the fish notices the shark, but the shark doesn't really see it. So I just got a shocked expression for my fish. And this scene, it might be my most important scene. The fish lines up with the seaweed and it hides from the shark and stays super still as the shark passes along by. And here is my last scene. The shark is swimming away and the fish is happy because the shark didn't see it and it's able to get away. So, as you can tell over my storyboard, I didn't have one angle the whole time. I had some scenes of just the fish, just the shark, some shots from far away. So you're going to want to think about this for your own storyboard. We're just going to do that to keep our animation interesting. So, now, looking at my storyboard, you might actually be able to make the animation yourself because it gave so much information about what the story is, but it's really just one page with 6 separate scenes. So you're going to aim for something like this for your storyboard. So you can look back at it while you're animating, but also you can have a nice plan of what you want for your story and make sure that it's split up wide enough that each scene will make sense, but close enough that they all flow together. And that's it. That's all you need to know about storyboarding. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I can't wait to see what you come up with. Please subscribe so you don't miss out on any video. Bye!